Yeah.
Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening to the distinguished scholars, engineers, delegates, participants, and moderators in the different locations on the globe of the world. I wish like to introduce my sincerely thank to the conference committee and the conference company to give me a chance to deliver my talk at this important conference. I am sure you agree with me that this is a multidisciplinary conference and every scientist is not familiar every subject of the science. Therefore, at the beginning of my talk, I will introduce the basic terms and definition related to the shape memory effect and superelasticity. As you can see, the title of my presentation is Thermomechanical and Thermoresponsive Reactions in the Reversibility of Shape Memory Alloys. Unfortunately, I cannot change the slides.
Use the keyboard buttons, doctor. Right, up, down, left.
Yeah, I am using left, right, but.
Yes, keep the cursor. Keep the cursor on the presentation once, then click on the down and right arrows. Yeah, click on it.
Sorry?
Click on the presentation once.
Yeah, I will start, but I cannot change the slides.
Okay.
Can I stop and
yes, stop and share again. Stop and
yeah,
share
okay,
again.
Thank you very much.
Yeah.
I think it is okay now.
Yeah.
The title of my presentation is Thermomechanical and Thermoresponsive
Reactions. Doctor, can you keep it in presentation mode?
Yeah.
Yeah, click on that.
Yeah.
Beside minus button, the minus symbol is there, right? Beside that, yes, click on that.
Yeah, okay.
Okay. Yeah.
Shape memory alloys are thermoresponsive materials and exhibit a peculiar property called shape memory effect. This behavior is initiated by cooling and deformation processes and perform thermal on heating and cooling in the bulk level. And this behavior can be called thermal memory or thermoelasticity. These alloys can be plastic deformed in low temperature condition and record the original shape just by thermal means on heating over the reverse osmotic transformation temperature after removing the strain. These materials cycle between deformed and original shapes on cooling and heating. These alloys exhibit another property called superelasticity, which is performed by mechanical stresses in a constant temperature, and this behavior can be called mechanical memory. This is main processes for thermal memory or shape memory effect. Shape memory effect is initiated on cooling and deformation. On cooling, shape of the material doesn't change, but crystallography transformations occur in the atomic level. Second step is the deformation, and this is plastic deformation, and the material keeps the deformed shape after releasing external strain due to the plastic deformation. On heating, material record the original shape by means of reverse osmotic transformation, and shape of the material cycle between deformed shape and original shape on cooling and heating. Shape memory effect and superelasticity is result of the crystallographic transformations, thermal and stress-induced martensitic transformations, and evaluated by the structural change in atomic scale. Shape memory effect is performed thermally in a temperature interval depending on the forward austenite Martin site and reverse Martin site austenite transformations on cooling and heating. Superelasticity is performed in different austenite phase region just above the austenite finish temperature. For the superelasticity, materials are stressed in different phase region and shape recovery is performed instantly and simultaneously upon releasing applied stress. This is temperature hysteresis of shape memory aldrich. In the shape memory effect, thermal induced martensitic transformation occurs on cooling and start at MS temperature and completed at MF temperatures. Here MS is martensitic start and MF is martensitic finish temperatures. On heating, reverse austenitic transformations occur and start at AS temperatures and completed at F temperatures. These are the stress-strain characteristics in shape memory effect and superelasticity. In the shape memory effect, the materials are deformed at the low temperature condition. As you can see, early stages of the deformation exhibit elastic material behavior. In the superelasticity, material is stressed in the parent phase region. As you can see, stressing and releasing paths are different and hysteresis loops refers to the energy dissipation. This is another stress-strain behavior of shape memory aldrich at the temperature between martensitic finish and austenite start temperature. As you can see, stress-strain profile exhibit different characteristics based on shape memory effect and superelasticity. This is another illustration of shape memory effect and superelasticity. In the shape memory effect, the material is deformed at the low temperature condition. This is a plastic deformation and strain energy is stored in the materials and released on heating by recovering the original shape. And shape of the material cycle between original shape and deformed shape on heating and cooling. In the superelasticity, material is stressed in the parent phase region and shape recovery is performed simultaneously upon releasing the external strain by exhibiting elastic material behavior. This is schematic of shape memory cycle in the crystallographic level. Let me inform you that shape memory effect and superelasticity is observed in the beta phase region of the material and ordered phase structure is essential. In the shape memory effect, first step is cooling and on cooling, ordered parent phase structures turn into the determined martensitic structures by means of thermal induced martensitic transformation. And by the deformation, this structure turn into the determined martensitic structure by means of stress induced martensitic transformation. And on heating, determined martensitic structure turn into the ordered parent phase structures and crystal structure of material cycle between ordered parent phase structures and determined martensitic structures on heating and cooling. This is also a schematic of superelasticity in the crystallographic level. In the superelasticity, the material is stressed in the elastic limit in the parent phase region and ordered parent phase structures turn into the determined martensitic structures by means of stress-induced martensitic transformation. Upon releasing, determined martensitic structures turn into the ordered parent phase structures by means of reverse austenitic transformation. This is a three-dimensional illustration of shape memory mechanism. This is ordered parent phase structures. On cooling, ordered parent phase structures turn into the determined martensitic structures by means of thermal induced martensitic transformations. And twinned martensitic structures turn into the detwinned martensitic structures with the deformation. And on heating, detwinned martensitic structures turn into the ordered parenteral structures and cycle between ordered parenteral structures and detwinned martensitic structures on heating and cooling. Super elasticity is also linked with stress-induced martensitic transformation, which is induced by applying mechanical stress. With this stress, parent austenitic phase structures turn into the completely detwinned martensitic structure, as in the deformation step of Shapemomere effect. Then, detwinned martensitic structures turn into the parent-based structure upon releasing the external stress. The crystal structure of the material cycle between parent-based structures and detwinned martensitic structures on stressing and releasing. It is important that stress strain curve exhibit nonlinear behavior and stressing and releasing paths are different, and hysteresis loop refers to the energy dissipation. This is the stressing and releasing path in the superelasticity. By this stressing, ordered parent-phase structures turn into the detwinned martensitic structures by means of stress-induced martensitic transformation, and ordered parent-phase structures turn into the detwinned martensitic structures. Martensitic transformation is a first-order solid-state fast transition and, of course, in a few steps with the cooperative movement of atoms in displacer manner. Therefore, these transitions have diffusionless character and product martensitic phase inherits the order of parent austenitic phase. Martensitic transformations mainly occur into basic step in the beta phase region of material. These are vein distortion and lattice invariant shapes. These are the basic beta phase structures in the beta phase region of the material. Vein distortion is mainly affected in ternary coupled Shapemomere Aldous and consists of an expansion of 26% in O1 type axis called vein axis and a compression of 11% in the 1-1 type direction perpendicular vein axis. There are two vein axes, 1-0, O1-0, and O1-0, and BCC-based unit cells turn into the body-centric tetragonal structures as trivariant in different orientations. Lattice invariant shapes occur as martensitic variants on 1-1 type planes of austenitic matrix, which is basal plane of martensites. And dash shapes occur into opposite direction, 1-1 type direction on the 1-1 type planes. The 1-1 type planes family represents 13 planes and totally 24 martensitic variants of course. These planes are listed as follows: 1-1-0, -1-1-0, 1-0-1, -0-1, 0-1-1, 0-1, -1. Lattice invariant shapes and lattice twinning is not uniform in coupled shape of our lives, and this has caused the formation of layer structures. 1-1 type planes of parent phase turn into the unusual layer structure, which consists of an array of closed packet planes with complicated stacking sequences called as 3R, 9R, or 18R martensitis, depending on the stacking sequences on the closed packet planes of the order of lattice. The periodicity and therefore the unit cell is completed through 18 layers in directions that in case of 18R martensitic structures. This is the formation of the layer structures. This is the stacking of 1-1 type planes of austenitic matrix. And with the lattice invariances, the stackings turn into the dash stackings ABC, BCA, CAB, and A4-18R martensitic structures. This is another illustration of the layer structure for DO3 type crystal structures and 18R martensitic structures. These are the basic terms and definitions related to the shape memory effect and superelasticity. Experimental studies were performed to copper based shape memory alloys. These are copper zinc aluminium and copper aluminium mangan alloys. You can see the alloy composition and these compositions were selected in the metaphase region of the material. As you can see, martensite start and martensite finish temperatures are over the room temperatures, and both of the alloy samples are in the product martensitic state at the room temperatures. Specimens obtained from these alloys were solution treated for homogenization and at the beta phase field as following, then quenched in ice grain and aged at room temperatures. These homogenization temperatures are 830 and 700 degrees for copper zinc aluminium and copper aluminium alloys, and these temperatures were selected in the beta phase field of the materials. Powdered specimens for X-ray examination were prepared by filling the alloys, and the specimens were sealed in evacuated quartz tube and during beta phase homogenization treatments in order to release the strain and external effect. These temperatures are also the same, and homogenization times were selected 15 minutes, both of the alloy samples. Powder diffractorums were obtained for all the specimens at the different stage of aging in a long time interval. This is an X-ray diffractorum taken from copper zinc aluminium alloy samples after long-term aging at room temperature about 15 years after quenching. As you can see, peak intensities are different, and this diffractorum exhibit superlattice reflection. Let me inform you that these peak pairs are important for the copper-based shape memory alloys. These are 1-2-2-202, 1-2-8-208, 1-2-10-2-010, and others. This is another X-ray diffractorum taken from copper aluminium mangan alloy samples after long-term aging at room temperature, about 15 years after quenching. As you can see, this diffractorum also exhibits the same characteristics with these plain pairs. A series of X-ray diffractorums have been taken from both of the alloy samples in a long time interval, and some change have been observed in diffraction angles and peak intensities and peak characteristic with age and duration. In particular, some of the successive peak phase have shifted toward each other, and these peaks provide the following relation between Miller indices for 18R martensite. As I mentioned, these plain pairs can be listed as hollow for 18R structures. I mentioned on the diffraction patterns, 1-2-2-0-2, 1-2-8-2-0-8, 1-2-10-2-0-10, 0-4-0, and 3-2-0. At the long-term investigation, it is observed that these peak pairs come close each other with age and duration, and this change reveals the changes in the crystal structure of material. The basal plane of martensite is subjected to the hexagonal distortion with martensite formation on which atom size have important effect. In case the atoms occupying the lattice size have the same size, the basal plane of martensite becomes regular hexagon. Otherwise, deviations occur from the hexagonal arrangement of the due to the atom size are different. In the disordered case, all of the lattice size are occupied randomly and atomic sizes can be taken approximately equal each other. In the ordered case, lattice size are occupied regularly by certain atoms which have different atomic sizes and Bessel plane deviates from the regular hexagonal arrangement of the atoms due to the atom size differences. This rectangular shape is the Bessel plane of the parenthesis, and with the Martensitic transformation, the Bessel plane turned into the hexagonal shape. In the disordered case, randomly distribution, we can take atom sizes approximate equal each other, and this hexagonal becomes normal hexagonal. In the ordered case, neighbor atom sizes are different and deviations occur from the normal hexagonal arrangement. Second experimental study was performed on the transmission electron microscope by taking electron diffraction patterns. As you can see, electron diffraction patterns also exhibit superlattice reflections. Shape-Mamer effect is evaluated by the structural change in microscopic scale by means of Martensitic transformation. The fundamental structures of beta-type martensites are orthorhombic closed packet structure, which consists of an array of closed packet planes in coupled-based Shape-Mamer alloys. The beta-type martensites have the layered structures and are characterized by the stacking sequences depending on the order in parenthesis. Coupled-based ternary alloys have the deuterotide superlattice in parent austenite phase ranging, and the following stacking sequences occur with martensitic transformation. The sequences are AB, CB, CA, CA, BA, BC, BC, AC, AC, and AB for 18 are martensitic structures. On the basis of austenite martensitic relation, the basal plane of 9R or 18R martensites originate from one of the 1-1R planes of the parent phase, on which lattice invariances occur into opposite direction with the martensitic transformations. These are the references, and thank you very much for your attention. If anybody has questions, I'll try to answer. Questions, comments?